हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वी विल सी वेबसाइट डेवलपमेंट यूजिंग वर्डप्रेस। हाउ टू डेवलप अ वेबसाइट यूजिंग वर्डप्रेस। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। हियर इज द वर्डप्रेस ओवरव्यू। व्हाट इज एग्जैक्टली द वर्डप्रेस? वर्डप्रेस इज एन ओपन सोर्स कंटेंट मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम विच अलाउज द यूजर्स टू बिल्ड डायनामिक वेबसाइट्स एंड ब्लॉग्स। WordPress is the most popular blogging system on the web and allow updating, customizing and managing the website from its backend CMS and components. So it is basically a CMS which allows users to build dynamic websites and blogs. It is also most popular blogging website. So what is exactly the content management system, CMS? The content management system is a software which stores all the data such as text, photos, music, documents, etc. and is made available on your website. It helps in editing, publishing, modifying the content of the website. It is all related to the content, so CMS will help you to edit, publish and modify the content. WordPress was initially released on 27th May 2003 by Matt Mullenweg and Mike Little. And WordPress was announced as an open source in October 2009. It is the most important thing that it announced as an open source in October 2009. So CMS will allow us to edit the text, photos, music, documents on a web page easily. So what are the features of WordPress? Here are some features. WordPress एक CMS platform है जो हमें हमारी website easily modify और manage करने में मदद करता है, और वो हमें एक platform provide करता है जिससे हम ये विदाउट कोडिंग कर सकते हैं। तो हम आगे देखते हैं वर्डप्रेस के फीचर्स क्या हैं। व्हाट आर द फीचर्स ऑफ वर्डप्रेस? यूजर मैनेजमेंट इज द वन ऑफ द मेन फीचर ऑफ वर्डप्रेस इन विच वी कैन क्रिएट मल्टीपल यूजर्स रोल्स एज अ मैनेजर। सो नेक्स्ट फीचर इज मीडिया मैनेजमेंट, वेयर वी कैन मैनेज द मीडिया फाइल्स एंड फोल्डर्स and organize, upload and manage that files in our website. Third feature is theme management. We can modify the site view and functionality using different themes. Fourth is the extend with plugins. We can use plugins which are available in wordpress.com and we can modify our website using that plugins. Fifth is the search engine optimization. WordPress sites are makes on-site SEO simple. And seventh is the multilingual. That is, we can convert entire content of our website. That is, we can translate the entire content into the language we preferred. And last is the importers. So we can import the data from the post and files pages. So here are the WordPress features. Then we will see what is WordPress advantages. Advantages of WordPress are many. We have listed few of the important advantages here. So WordPress is open source platform and it is available for free from 2009. CSS files can be designed as per the user needs. Many plugins and templates are available for free. It is very easy to edit the content, as it provides what you see is what you get interface. Media files can be uploaded easily and quickly. It is on-site SEO simple. Customization is easy according to the user needs. It allows creating different roles. for users for websites such as admin, user, author, editor, and contributor. So, what we require for installing WordPress and using WordPress in our computer or a laptop. So, what we require is a database, MySQL 5.0 plus version, web server, WAMP, LAMP, XAMPP, MAMP, operating system cross platform, browser, any browser that is either Internet Explorer, Firefox, or Google Chrome, or Safari, or Opera, PHP compatibility, PHP 5.2 plus. So, what we require is only a XAMPP server, because XAMPP server includes the database, PHP, and Apache. So, what we require is the only the XAMPP server. So, we have to download the XAMPP server from the Apache site and install in it our system so that the WordPress can work easily. So now we will see how to install WordPress in our system. So for installing the WordPress, we have to go to WordPress.org site, which is the official website of WordPress, and we have to go to the WordPress.org/download. Here it is the web page of the WordPress where we can download the setup of WordPress 5.4.2, which is the latest one. After downloading the setup, we are getting the zip file of the WordPress folder that we have to unzip and paste into the XAMPP folder, XAMPP htdocs, and we have to paste it into the htdocs folder. When we install XAMPP, it installs in a C drive. XAMPP is the folder which we got from installing the XAMPP, and after installing the XAMPP, we have XAMPP htdocs folder. In htdocs, we have to place this WordPress unzip file to this location so that it can work easily. We have pasted here WordPress file which we have downloaded from the official website of the WordPress. So next step is the running the localhost. Before that, we have to open the XAMPP control panel and start the Apache and MySQL service so that localhost can work properly. Now we will see whether our localhost is working properly or not. We can type here localhost. So the localhost XAMPP page is coming up. It says that the XAMPP is installed correctly. XAMPP includes the Apache, MariaDB, PHP, and Perl, and MySQL database also. So it is the localhost is working correctly. So now we will see whether our WordPress folder is accessible or not. For that, we have to type localhost slash WordPress. Yes, it is accessible because we have pasted that folder in htdocs, XAMPP htdocs folder. So now we will select English as a language. After that, we have getting this page database information, database name, database username, database password, database host, and table prefix. For running this page or for going ahead, we have to create one database for the WordPress. So for that, we have to go to the XAMPP control panel and MySQL admin, so that the MySQL admin page will open and we can create the new database name MyDB. I am giving the database name as a MyDB. Only we are here creating the database, no any table or nothing. So create the new database in phpMyAdmin. phpMyAdmin is the interface of the MySQL. So we are, after clicking here new, we are creating the database. I am giving name as a MyDB. We have to remember this name, and I am selecting it as a UTF-8 CI, general CI, as the, and create. Here database is created. This is the first step where we have to create the database for the installation of the WordPress setup. So now we will go to the next step, where we are providing the database name which we have created right now. MyDB is the database name which we have created earlier, MyDB. Then the, we are providing username as a root, and password is the null, and all the fields are making same. Yes, if you get this page, then your database connection is successful. If you have any problem, then please go to the phpMyAdmin and create the database and repeat the step which you have stated earlier. So now run the installation. Here we have started the creation of our WordPress website. So we have to give the site title. So I am giving here my site as the site title. Username I am giving here as admin, and I am giving here password as admin @123. These both things we have to remember, because it is required for the login of the WordPress control panel. So our username is the admin and password is admin@123. We are, for the demonstration purpose, we are making password very weak. For your website, you can create the strong password. So click on the confirm use of the weak password. Here you are providing your email ID. I am providing here sample email ID. You can provide your original email ID. Next option is the search engine visibility. You do not have to do anything here, and just click on the install WordPress. यहाँ हमारा वर्डप्रेस का जो सेटअप है वो अबाउट टू कंप्लीट हो रहा है. आफ्टर इंस्टॉलिंग द वर्डप्रेस, व्हाट वी आर गेटिंग इज द होल वर्डप्रेस इंटरफेस. बिफोर दैट वी हैव टू लॉग इन टू द वर्डप्रेस पैनल. सो our username is the WordPress has been installed successfully. Thank you and enjoy. So username is the admin and password your chosen password. We have chosen password as the admin@123. So we will log in with that same credentials. Our username is admin and password is admin@123. So we will log in with the credentials which we have created earlier. Now, if you see this dashboard, you can say that you have successfully installed WordPress in your computer and your localhost is running the WordPress interface. So now we will see what is the that interface is. Here we can see the dashboard. Here it is the dashboard block. Then PHP update is the here is the PHP update block. Now we will see one by one the setting of our website. We have created my site as our website. We'll first do some general settings and then general. So our site title is my site, tagline is just another WordPress site. You can change this. I will change this and update this and you will see the changes afterwards. So our WordPress address is the localhost/WordPress. Site address is the same. Administration email ID is abc@123. This email ID is required for sending the email to your users. So please provide the valid email ID so that you can alert the users about your many features. So membership, anyone can register. Here is the time zone. So site language, here we can select as English. Time zone we would select as our Indian time zone, UTC+5:30, and date format is here. So July 14, 2020, we can select this as a date format. You can change also time format is the 5:23 p.m. Now week starts on Monday. We can keep the changes and save the changes. These are the general settings. Now we will see what are the settings in writing. So we will click on writing. Post category. WordPress is basically used for the blogging sites and it is for content management. So a lot of posts are there, like Facebook post, you can say lot of posts are there. So you can set the default post category. It is uncategorized. Default post format standard. Mail server, you have to send the mail or post mail via email. So here you can specify the mail server and the port number and the login credentials of that mail server. That is, I am talking about the sender credentials, sender login name and password. And you can save the changes. After saving the writing setting, we move ahead to the reading. So reading setting, your home page displays your latest post. If I post any latest update, that post will be at the top, not at the bottom. Here we are specifying this. Blogs pages shows at most. So 10 posts we can show on a one page. This is the meaning of this field. Syndication feeds show the most 10 recent items. Full text search engine visibility. We can save changes. Now we will see what is the setting under the discussion. So attempt to notify any blog like link to from the post. So here are the some settings related to the notifications of the post. If any new post is there, we are notifying the users. We can keep the changes as it is. It is by default. So we will move ahead to the media settings. Here the thumbnail size we can change. 150 by 150 pixel is the thumbnail size. We can change or we can increase or decrease the thumbnail size here. I am not changing anything here. Organize my uploads into month and year based folders. So we can uncheck or check this setting for uploading the files. Now the next is the permalink. Permalink is the default setting, so I am not changing here anything. Next is the setting under privacy. So we can change here, we can set the privacy policy of our website as per the different national rules. We are setting the privacy or according to the laws of any nation, we are setting the privacy here. So these are the settings which we have to do before the we are running the website. Now we will see the dashboard. What is exactly the dashboard of the WordPress site? So for that we will see the how to customize our site. We are getting one default template here and we are customizing that template according to our need. So customize your site is the option we have selected here. Hame WordPress mein by default themes milte hai aur usse hum wo changes kar pate hai jo hame chahiye. So this it is the by default theme provided by the WordPress. Here the my site which is name given by us earlier, and it is the tagline. We can change that tagline here also. We can change the tagline here. Welcome to my world. Welcome to my world. And we can, it is the site identity. First option at the left top is the site identity, where we can select the logo of our website, site title, tagline and site icon. We can upload here. Now we will only update the tagline and publish. So you will see the change in the tagline. That is welcome to my site, welcome to my world. So next, after we have selected 2020 theme here by default theme, we can change the theme also after clicking this. Here are some templates available, or we can select that templates and we can change the site as per our needs. So right now we have selected the 2020 theme. We have seen the site identity. After that we will see the colors. We can change the background color we are changing for your information. So here the background color is changed because we have selected here the yellow color. We are making that as default. So we can change the header footer background color. Here you can see the white is the background color of header footer. Now we will change that color according to our demand. So we will change this as a green. So for your information, I am telling you this. Now we will set to the default. Now we will move ahead with the theme option. Here show the search bar in header. If we uncheck this option, then the search bar here will be discarded. So here are some tabs provided by default with the default theme. So home is the tab, about is the tab here, about is the tab here, it is the header, about this site and find us, blog is the tab, horizontal tabs are here. Here is one blog is there, hello world, and it is posted by admin on July 14. One comment is here, and contact us tab is also here. So here are the horizontal tabs. Also there is horizontal vertical tabs provided in the menu. So home, about us, blog, these are the vertical tabs, and this is the search button. If we want to search any post, say hello, so we can search that post in our site. So it is the basically the search bar of our website. Yes, we have found one result, it is the hello world. So we have searched hello, it is matched with this post, and the post we are getting, show author bio, we can check or uncheck this. Then cover template, you can see here the cover template is brownish or reddish one. You can change the color of this. Text color you can also change. Fix background you can check or uncheck. Then next is the background image. If you want to give any image as a background image, you can upload here and publish, so that changes will be reflected. After that, menus. It is the most important part of any website, menus. So here are the primary menus like home, about us, blog and contact. Home, about, blog and contact. We are creating another menu called product. We are giving name as the product. So product is our new menu which we are adding here. So you will see the product menu added here. Product menu is added here. We can reorder this. We can change the order of the product menu. So now you will see that the product menu will be your second menu item. So we can change our reorder, or we can add the menu here. And the next is the, these are the horizontal menus, primary horizontal menus. Other are the primary vertical menus. If we add one menu called ID, so this menu will be added to our horizontal menu bar. We are publishing this. After publishing, only the changes will be reflected in actual site. As we can see that ID menu is added here, and we can assign any page to that menu so that it will open later. So some social media links are here, so we can change that link also, and we can give our social media locations or our identities to this menu here. So you can give your URL here so that it will directly go to your Facebook page or your Twitter page or your Instagram page or your email ID directly. So this is about the social media links. So this is the most important part, menus, which we have seen. Then another is the widgets, where you can edit the footers, like about this site. You can change this footer name about my site. We are changing here for your reference. So this will be changed. You can change the content also. You can publish. So in this way, you can change the widgets. Footer too, you can also change as per your address and working hours. You can change the widgets. You can add any of the widgets here. So home page setting, next part is the home page setting. Our home page is now the you can see the home page is the new Umoma opens its doors. So we can change the home page as a about. So every time the home page will open as about. So we are setting as the default. We don't want to change anything here. So now the additional CSS we can provide. So here we can provide the additional CSS files. We can change here. We can provide additional CSS for the design purpose, and we can change here. So these are the some customized changes we can do in our provided theme. You can also download the WordPress theme from the wordpress.org, and you can use that theme. This is our look at our site, default site. So here is the blogs that we are talking. So these are some customizations which we have done. Now we will see what we can do in the dashboard. So we can add any page, any media or any post to our website through the dashboard. And this is the our visit site menu. If you click this, we are opening this in new tab so that you can see the changes. So this is the overall interface of our site. Okay, so if you change the theme, the overall interface also change, but the content will be the same. We are changing the theme to 2017. So live preview we will see. This is the 2017 theme. The content is the same, only the design or the view is the change. Then we can select the WordPress.org theme and apply to our site. So now we will see the one by one the options in the dashboard. So first is the home. Here is the visit site we have seen. Here are the plugins, one plugin and two themes are there. It is the shortcut for creating new post, media, page, user directly here. And this is the home of our WordPress. We can directly go to the WordPress.org here. We can see the documentation, we can see the support, or we can see the feedback, or we can give the feedbacks here. So after that, the first option is the post. After clicking all posts, we can see the here are one post is there only, Hello World, which we have seen here. Hello World is the post, or we can say we have named it as a blog, Hello World. So you can add the post here by clicking add new. You can add the post. You can change the category of any post. Now it is the uncategorized, so you can change the category also. We are adding one new post here for your information. So I will add my or tech world. It's me. So we are publishing this post. Now you will see the changes that right now the post is only one Hello World. We are created new post Tech World. So after publishing, you will see that post reflected here. The Tech World is the updated post and the Hello World post is the latter post. So updated post will be at the top. Now in all posts you will see two posts, Hello World and Tech World. So you have seen the changes. After that you can change the category. Next option is the media. So you can change the media settings here. You can change the media setting, add new media. You can add the new media here. You are dropping here the files. Then the next option is the pages. The first we will see which pages are present. So about, blog, contact, ID, privacy. Privacy, product, sample page. These are the pages already present. We can add the page from here or here also. After adding that page will be added to our specified location, which we are specifying. So we will add some page called product details. And publishing. This page is published. Now we will see where the location is. We can change the location also. Here we will see where that page is created. Provide details. You can edit the location here. Then we move to the comment part. Here we can add the comment or we can view the comment. Next is the appearance, where we can change the themes of our website directly. You can install the new themes from here, from the WordPress.org. And you can use that theme as your design. You can also customize the theme, as we have seen. You can customize the theme, and you can change the theme options, cover templates, background image here. So it is under the theme section. Now we will see what is plugins. Plugins is the additional or add-on which we are adding to our website, like SMS sending gateway is the, we can say, the plugin, or we can say the interactive pop-up is the plugin. So we will install that plugin via this option. We can add new plugin or install the earlier plugins here. Plugins and the themes is the important feature of the WordPress, and we can customize that themes and plugins according to our needs. Next is the users of our system. We can authenticate the users by creating different modules called admin, user, guest, or customer module, and we can give the different roles or privileges to that users. Here we can add new user here by submitting this all details. The new user will be created. Now our only user is the admin, which is using our website. So we can change the admin settings here. Now the tools are the available tools: import, export tools, site health. Site health is the important tool where we can see the health of our site, that the whether the our site is secure or not, which plugin or which theme has the problem, which problem it is having. So we will see all the details here. Results are loading. One critical issue is here. The site is running on outdated version of PHP, so we have to update the PHP version. It is saying we should remove the inactive plugins. If there is any inactive plugin, so you can remove that. Like suggestions, it is site health is giving. It is loaded. Should be improved. Our site can be improved as a security or as a safety. We can improve our site. We can export the data from here. We can erase the personal data from here. So we have seen all the settings: general setting, writing setting, reading, discussion, media, permalink, privacy earlier. So this is the overview of the WordPress, how we can what is the use of WordPress, what is CMS, what is exactly the use of WordPress, features, advantages of WordPress, then the system requirements of the WordPress. Then we have seen step by step the installation of the WordPress. For that you have to install the XAMPP server, and then you will go to the WordPress installation. For the WordPress installation, we have to create one database called MyDB or anything you want. Then you can move ahead to the installation. You can customize your page, you can add the theme, you can add the plugins to your customized theme, you can change the pages, menus, you can change the design, you can change the overall look of your website easily without doing any code. So here we can see that we have created MyDB as a blank database, but after creating full installation or after doing full installation and site, we have directly getting these tables and all the data. So this is the advantage of the WordPress, that we don't have to connect our database to our website through the code. It is directly connecting and it is getting our desired output. So this is all about the step-by-step tutorial of website development using WordPress. The download link for the XAMPP and the WordPress setup is given in the description. So refer that description, like, comment and share my video so that everyone can be benefited and make the most of it. So subscribe to my channel, and thank you very much for your patient listening.